I call to order the January 22nd, 2018 regular council meeting and ask for a roll call, please.
Bobby Mock.
Excused.
Catherine Whitman.
Here.
Chris Baca.
Tardy.
Robin Dunlap.
Here.
Debbie Nasta.
Here.
Joe Baker.
Here. We have a quorum established and ask everyone in the audience to please join us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, thanks everyone for doing that. Oof. No worries. All right, next on the agenda is anything, public comments not on schedule on the agenda. If you have anything you'd like to speak about that's not on the agenda this evening, please come to the podium. Seeing none, I'm going to close that and move to the consent agenda. The consent agenda is generally made with one motion and all one vote, usually, unless council sees fit to take something off the agenda and put it on general business. If not, I will read out the agenda. Consent agenda is the minutes of the 2018 January 8th regular meeting. Accounts payable dated today, January 22nd, in the amount of $624,446.30. Acknowledgement of the receipt of November 2017 financial statements. Resolution 1810 adopting an American with Disabilities policy of non-standardized response to, hang on a second. Oh, there we go. Non-discrimination. There we go. Sorry about that. I had a little bit of a brain cramp. I jumped around. 1810 adopting Americans with Disabilities policy of non-standardized response. Sorry, I keep jumping past that, don't I?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. All right, let's try this again. And reasonable accommodation request form, complaint form, and standardized response to reasonable accommodation form. Did I get that right this time?
There you go.
Wow, that brain hurts, man. It's definitely a whole month of Mondays in January for old Joe. Resolution 1811, applications for water shares and will serve agreement for Autumn Valley Ranch Subdivision. Resolution 1812, approving an agreement with BBC Research and Consulting, Inc. for oil and gas fiscal evaluation. Resolution 1813, approving the expenditure of the amount of $23,309.26 to Weld County for 2018 public safety communications cost allocations for dispatch services. And Resolution 1814, approving an agreement with Community Services to provide creation and support of a themed economic development website to the city of Dacono. Whoosh. Sorry about that, guys. Apologize. It's been a rough morning, rough day. Council, anyone sees fit to take anything off the agenda, put it towards public, general business, excuse me. If not, I would accept the motion as presented.
I'd make a motion to accept the consent agenda as presented.
Motion by Robin, second by Kathy. Can we receive a vote, please?
Catherine?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Oh, that motion passes with everyone saying yes. My goodness. Wow. All right, thanks for letting me walk through that one. Like I said, it's been a full month of Mondays for old Joe. That concludes the consent agenda. We're going to bounce around a little bit. And we're going to talk about the appointment of the council seat. The reason why we need that is because we need a full quorum. So we have an applicant here. Everyone knows this applicant. We had another applicant come in late on arrival, but that person was not able to do interviews. So quite frankly, I think everyone knows the person that we're talking about is Kevin Plain. He's here this evening, definitely willing to serve. He's served in the capacity for 9 years. I think 2.5 of those years was mayor pro tem. He's also served for about a year and a half as the planning commissioner, chairman of the board. So he's got about 10 and a half years experience with the city of Dacono. I would like to accept a motion to appoint Kevin Plain to the council seat that's vacant.
I'll make the motion to appoint Kevin Plain to the vacant council seat vacated by Nick Vogel. I was going to say Vic Nogle. Yeah, see, it's a Monday.
I'm rubbing off on Debbie.
There you go. Second.
All right, we'll give that one to Robin. Motion by Debbie, second by Robin. Can we receive a vote, please?
Catherine? Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
And Joe, right? Yes.
No, you don't get a vote.
I don't get a vote on that one?
No, but can you take a brief,
Tape?
Pause so that I can go get the oath for him?
Oh, yes. We're gonna pause for a second. That motion passes with everyone saying yes. We're gonna have Mr. Plain come up to the, seat. And, she's gotta get an oath for him to sign and drop of blood and DNA sample, saliva swab, hair follicle.
Firstborn?
Kevin, apologies that your family can't be here for your swearing in again.
No, I'm good, thank you. Yes.
We came to answer your questions.
Kevin said don't come because he doesn't want to be nervous while he's interviewed.
Yeah, you don't want to make me nervous.
I think I make you more nervous than anybody.
I was very prepared to.
Were you really?
Yeah, I was.
We have.
Practicing in front of Mary.
We didn't even have any questions. Would you like something to drink? Glass of water or something? Sure. No, we got it. Mine was open. Was yours open?
Yours was open.
Probably by one of the...
Oh, is that the roofie water?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. You'll know tonight when I call you and start texting at 3 o'clock in the morning. I love you, man. You're the greatest. Right? Yeah, as soon as you start getting text messages from me at 3 in the morning. Right. I'll text my boss. Probably handwriting it right now because it has to be done in longhand, like you do the Constitution. So, we the people, in order to form a more perfect union. So,
yeah.
Okay. Just saying. You have to recite the first paragraph of the Constitution.
So, how does the other party get notified?
They'll get an email tomorrow.
Okay.
Yeah. Everybody gets emails tomorrow. Or you can tell them Sunday if you want. No, they'll be notified tomorrow. Yeah. Ominous silence. Hopefully they'll cut all my babbling out.
Since we have a few minutes and I don't know how I'm gonna do this on the tape, we're gonna like go into recess, but
one? Come?
No.
That's the best one? Saturday?
Huh,
that's kind of the best one. You can slip in, eat, and leave.
So far, so good.
Okay. Have Kevin come.
Should we take a picture? Oh, your camera?
No. Have Kevin come. Can you put that up here for me, please? Just so happens that purely by chance, put them right there. Right? How does that work, right? Just saying.
Did you throw his ring that one?
We didn't throw his old sign away.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Thank you. Welcome back.
Thank
Welcome
you.
Back.
Thank you.
Come on up. Have a seat right here. All right. So you want me to bounce to that, or you want me to do
with him?
Yes.
You want me to bounce to that, or you want me to do the public hearing? Okay, well, for the record, yeah.
We have to reorder the agenda a little bit.
Right, so you want me to just do the public hearing now? I might as well.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sorry.
All right, so for the record, Chris Baca has arrived. She was late, that's why we just did Kevin Plain. But it all works out for the good of the of mankind, humankind, actually. So we're going to move to general business, and that is opening the public hearing for Ordinance 842, amending the Chapter 16 of the Dacono Municipal Code concerning oil and gas facility operations agreements on second reading. And I believe we defer to Kate. Jennifer, thank you. Come on up, please.
Mayor and Council, this is the second reading and public hearing for your consideration of ordinance number 842, an ordinance amending Chapter 16 of the Dacono Municipal Code concerning oil and gas facility operator agreements. Items to be entered into the public hearing record this evening include the Dacono Municipal Code and the staff report dated January 22nd, 2018. By way of background, the City of Dacono oil and gas regulations are contained in Chapter 16, Article 22 of the Dacono Municipal Code. You may recall that by Ordinance 841, which was adopted by the City Council on November 27, 2017, the Council did adopt a temporary moratorium until May 31, 2018, on accepting, processing, or approving any kind of land use application or special use permit related to within the city related to oil and gas exploration. However, the moratorium did specifically exclude oil and gas wells which would be authorized by an operator agreement and approved by the city council. So in order to reconcile, if you will, the ordinance 841 with the notion of an operator agreement, the Dacono Municipal Code needs to be amended. So there are two sections of the code that we're proposing to amend with Ordinance 842. The first section is Section 16-521, and it adds additional definitions, including updating what oil and gas operations or operation means, as well as defining what an operator agreement is. The second proposed amendment adds a new section, subsection 1, and you can see it highlighted in your staff report, that basically it provides for either authorization for oil and gas drilling through special use permit or an operator agreement. There are no other changes proposed at this time, and staff is recommending approval of Ordinance 842. On second reading, I should also mention that the Planning Commission did hold a public hearing on December 12, 2017 and did recommend approval of this change, and there have been no changes between the first and second reading. Are there any questions?
Questions for the Administration Council?
Thank you.
Public hearing, so if any comments to be made by the public. Seeing none, I'll close the public hearing and turn it back over to council either for discussion or motion.
Make a motion to approve the Ordinance 842, amending Chapter 16 of the Dacono Municipal Code concerning oil and gas facility operator agreements on the second reading.
Second. Nice, getting in there already, so we'll give it to Kev. So. Motion by Kathy, second by Kevin. Can we see your vote, please?
Debbie Nasta?
Yes.
Kevin Plank?
Yes.
Catherine Whitman?
Yes.
Chris Baca?
Yes.
Robin Dunlap?
Yes.
All right, that motion carries with all saying yes, and that ends, or no, excuse me, we have general business, which is appointment of boards and commissions. Council, if it's okay, I think we had some discussion, so we can maybe tackle just off the top of the line. So Board of Adjustments, I think we have one seat open, and Kathy had mentioned filling that seat. Would it be okay if Kathy filled Nick Vogel's seat as a chair as the Board of Adjustments?
Yes.
Anyone see any problem with that? So we need a motion, or so a motion to accept Kathy as a chairman for Board of Adjustments?
I'll make the motion to accept Kathy Whitman as the chairman for the Board of Adjustment.
Right.
Thank you.
Can I just do a single vote? So all in favor, signal by saying aye, or do you want me to individually vote for it? Wow. We're really... Okay, so motion by Debbie, second by Chris. Can we receive a vote, please?
Kevin?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
Chris?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
That motion passes with all saying yes. Next is Liquor Authority, and I believe we wanted to do, we talked about her having Irene fill that space. I'm sorry, Shelly filling that space. So if we can, if everyone's okay with that, can we have a motion?
Oh, I'm sorry. We have four openings for... Liquor Authority.
We have one permanent member and we have two alternates, so can we, do we have to fill?
You have two regular members and two alternates.
So take all three applicants?
So take Charlie, Shelley, Ryan? Thought we only had.
Irene, her seat is up, so there's four.
Oh, I thought.
Yellow means open.
Doesn't say open.
Oh. She did reply.
Okay. So we have three open seats and we have four open seats and four people applying. So do you want a motion to accept as presented or do you want a motion with names?
Motion with names and who they're going, if they're gonna be a regular member or an alternate member.
So I would accept the motion for Shelley Kittering, to be a regular member. I would accept a motion for Ryan Williams to be a regular member. And I would accept Irene to Irwin. Oh no, who else?
Charlie's the.
Charlie Everett to be a regular member, or no, an alternate.
Alternate.
Thank you. And then Irene as an alternate. Is that, sounds good?
And can I say?
Yeah.
So moved?
So moved, there we go, thank you. All right, can we see a vote, please?
Catherine?
Yes.
Chris?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Nice, and then we don't have to talk about personnel because that's not voted by us, correct? So we're over that. So Planning Commission's gotten a little bit tricky. So here's what's going on with the Planning Commission. Kevin Plain is the chairman of the Planning Commission. Kathy has graciously resigned from that seat, and I would like to have Kevin Plain reappointed to the Planning Commission. I'll appoint him as the chairman. I would like to have Scott Malkovich reappointed to the, he's the incumbent that applied to the Planning Commission. I would like to have Shelley Kettering, am I saying that right? Thank you, Kittering, appointed to the Planning Commission. And those are the three seats that are up, correct? That's okay, I'll say it one more time, but those are three seats, correct, AJ?
Yeah, Shelley would take Daryl's seat,
right.
He's not reapplying.
Right, Shelley will take Daryl's seat as a Planning Commission. Scott Malkovich will be reappointed for incumbent, and then Kevin Plain will be appointed this evening as another seat that's up.
So you still need one more?
No.
Yeah, you do.
Derek.
Oh, Derek, thank you very much. And Derek Warden to be appointed. Thank you, Kathy.
So, Mayor, I don't think my seat's up. I'm still on until 2019, so I don't think you have to.
You're on council now, so now you're going to be the
council.
Now you're up and
now
you're back in.
So you are different.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'd say not to interrupt me with the microphone, but I'm just kidding.
I'll try to make this motion.
Just playing up the camera, and I don't know what's wrong.
I'll try to make this motion, so correct me if I do something wrong. So here we go. For the Planning Commission appointments, we will remove Catherine Whitman, who's stepping down as a council rep, and appoint Kevin Plain as a council rep on the Planning Commission. We will reappoint Scott Matkovich. And then Shelley Kittering and Derek Warden for the open spots.
Second.
All right. Can we receive a vote, please?
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
Chris?
Yes.
Nice. Thank you. And then the next one's the Police Advisory Board, which we didn't realize that Ryan Williams is the incumbent and he reapplied. So I was just going to move forward him being reappointed to that seat, if that's okay.
So moved?
Yeah,
absolutely. There we go. Second, move. Let me see your vote, please.
Debbie?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
Chris?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
That motion passes with all saying yes, and that's done. Thank you very much, Council, for letting me rip right through that. And
could you do the Board of Adjustments?
Fumble and
opening on there.
Board of Adjustments?
Yeah, they did that.
Yeah, I did.
They did
Kathy.
That first.
Yeah,
very first
we did
one.
That first. Mm-hmm.
Oh, we just went right down the list. So Kathy's in. She was reappointed chair for Nick, and Tammy Meredith, is that?
So then we need one more, right?
Yeah, we need one more.
Oh, that's right.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, Shelley, catering. Can we see, or you want Scott? Who do you want?
Sure.
Sure.
Let's go, make a motion to appoint Shelley Kittering as a board member for the Board of Adjustments.
There we go. Motion and a second. Can we receive a vote, please?
Kevin?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
Chris?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
That motion passed with all saying yes. Thank you, council, and thank you, our city clerk, for keeping us all in line. Without these people, we wouldn't be able to do this job. Trust me, it's next time you're up at CML and you see all the city clerks counting all the votes for the CML league and all that, those people are rock stars. They really are, so. And that concludes general business. Thank you very much for putting up with us this evening, and we will go to staff reports and defer to AJ.
Thank you, Mayor. Just quick update on the meeting list. There's no planning commission meeting tomorrow. We've conducted the interview and appointment, and the next event will be February 12th city council meeting. There is a planning commission on the 13th. Saturday, February 17th is the Chamber of Commerce annual dinner. And in our little break, I got head counts on there. I'll follow up with Kevin on that. Thursday, February 22nd is Unity in the Community in Longmont. Got head counts on there too. And that's all I have, unless there are any questions.
Questions for the town manager, city manager? City manager. None?
None.
Any other reports? City clerk? Police, fire, planning, public works. Just checking. Council?
I have one.
Okay.
I had a talk for you mandated their neighborhood revitalization community group in Glen, which was held on the 11th of January at New Horizons. I'm getting together a list. I forwarded emails to all of you from two of them. One was for the flooding, and another one was for the neighborhood, what they've noticed with. I'm putting together a list of their concerns, mostly ADA and cleanup and just, you know, general concerns that the community has to try and come to group as together with the city to help make that environment a little more inviting so that everyone can use it. One of the issues was maybe another shelter at the park because we've got one and the family had gone, they've only been able to use it one time all summer. Because there was only one shelter. And when the family went there, it was already taken and gone. So they ended up going to Firestone.
Come to Four, is what you're talking about? Which?
Yeah.
Okay, sorry.
So, you know, even all that. So as those meetings progress, the next one is on February 8th at 6 to 7:30. And so if you know anyone from the Glens, it's the whole neighborhood revitalization, and they are actually getting a group together to help make the community bond so that they can start to take action to better the entire neighborhood.
Our restrooms are ADA approved though, at the Glens, right? And then
one of the concerns was the crossing, like from the U pump it across the street to 7-Eleven.
We only have like a crosswalk with like bright lights or something.
And Danny Long was one that was there, and he's only been in his chair 5 years, but when he's gotten stuck in the mud.
Yeah, he's stuck in the mud.
The 7-Eleven, and you're either on the highway, you know, which is not safe either, or we need to get some kind of crossing across there that's ADA compliant, and either for the kids, you know, to cross the street. So that was one of the big issues for safety concerns.
Yeah, that's been my rant for the past 3 years, so, or longer, but I agree with the accessibility, especially this summer's going to be up pretty soon. Springtime's going to be here. The kids that are not going to the splash park are going to want to go to the rec center, which is our rec center, so Carbon Valley, so I agree.
On that, can we get an update on the Habitat for Humanity?
Oh, when you come back?
No, the city donation.
Yeah, that was on the bills list.
Oh.
It's on the consent agenda.
I missed that, sorry.
That's all right. I signed the check.
So it's happening.
I know I signed that check, because.
Okay.
But the safety enhancements are.
They're coming.
They're in the works. Council approved the purchase of all the signage and equipment and everything. Just, you know, as soon as the season gets better, we can do that. But one of the things that, you know, once we get a list, you know, we can talk about when we do the budgeting for next year and what we can tackle. I mean, because some of that ADA stuff can be really expensive. You know, we've gone and increased the sidewalks recently, the size of the sidewalks, you know, on Cathy Street, actually, and the ones we've done last year and maybe the year before. But it's one of those, and the policies that council adopted tonight are for our insurance requirements. But with ADA, what you do is come up with the plan and then how feasible you can take off little bites at a time on that. But yeah, there's certainly opportunity for discussion and allocating funds towards that.
You know, if anyone hasn't noticed, there are new stop signs on 8th Street that are a little bit more noticeable.
Not yet.
Oh, not yet.
Yeah, but as soon as the weather gets nice.
I've seen them, I just haven't. They're not blinking yet, sorry. So, but yeah, hopefully we'll get all that stuff done. Like I said, I'm sure sometimes as a council member, government doesn't move as fast as you want it to, which is just how the system works. I mean, we push as hard as we can as a council, as a full body, as hard as we can with these managers and this administration. So, I mean, and they do a pretty good job accommodating us, but yeah.
And in all fairness, you know, we have had the direction.
Oh, yeah.
You know, just push Public Works really hard this year on some of their projects, you know, to finish up and complete, starting with the Veterans Memorial, the big infrastructure project, and just everything else normally. So, yeah, I'll totally own up to scheduling on that, because that's my...
That's my charge, but... We have full faith in you, AJ. We know we'll get it done. Like I said, sometimes I know I toe tap a lot sometimes with, and I blow up AJ's phone, not at 3 o'clock in the morning, but...
But tonight, today, anyway.
Darn close.
Today, you will.
Yeah. So I do know that it's definitely on the radar, so...
I'd like to make a comment for the record on all the applicants that came forward for the boards and commissions. It was really nice to see many people come forward and to actually fill all the spots, because we were open on several of them last year. So very appreciative. Not everybody was able to take a spot on some of the applications, but look forward to seeing them come forward next year, and we might need some more.
I agree. It comes back to my push for being able to compensate these commissioners and the council better than what they have been compensated with. That's going to be my rant every meeting we have, or every time I get an opportunity, which you just gave me, Debbie. I know it's a Tabor issue. I appreciate it being a Tabor issue. I think that we are truly responsible stewards of the taxpayers' money when it comes to the city of Dacono and the best interests of our citizens and ourselves at the same time. But I think that the council's underpaid. I think that the mayor's underpaid. I think that the commissioners are not paid. And quite frankly, there hasn't been a pay. We were doing our history at our Christmas party or our holiday party, and some of the things, reading some of those records that were in the logs. 1980 was the last. It went from $35 to $50. And that was from 77 to 1980. So within 3 years, they're already bumping up the council, and then it just fell on deaf ears. And I get all that, but realistically, the time that these commissioners put in, the time that these council members put in, they should be, I mean, I'm not saying to, you know, the sky's the limit and open checkbook, but they really should be compensated. So I'm going to push the administration to put it back on the ballot again, and I feel that we should do the best job we can to try to get it passed and tell the citizens why we're asking for more money. It's not that we're asking for more money ourselves. It's for the next set of council members and the next commissioners to keep pushing Dacono in the right direction, so we can look back upon the city 10, 20 years from now, even longer, and say we've done a justice by having a manageable, working, functional city. So, if that makes sense. Anything else down there, council?
Just wanted to thank everybody. I'm humbled and honored, and I promise I'll do my best.
Nice. And you're going to Unity Community, correct?
Yes, I will.
AJ, I'm gonna put him down for the unity community.
Do you mind if I keep this card for the
day? You can have that for the day.
All right.
Anything else down on this side? Thanks for the holiday party. Business-wise, I'm not gonna talk about the mayor pro temp till next time. I'm gonna probably have discussion on that or have it talked about. I'm gonna probably push for Kevin to be reappointed to that only because he brings the most experience to the table. He's been on the council longer than anybody, even myself. Well, I think we got each other. No, you got me by 3 years. Because you ran, you knocked on my door and I ripped it open and said, what do you want? I think I scared you when you...
Yeah, you did. I would also like to express interest in the position.
Right. So, appreciate that. So, I don't know if I could sit next to you professionally that long. I like you, but I don't know if I can handle you pecking in my ear for that much. So, that's my professional opinion. So, I also think Kevin might be able to attend a lot more of these meetings, but that's my own thing. So, but you're going to run this year for mayor, hopefully.
That's what you keep on saying, yeah. So I might as well just be mayor with the pro temp next year. Not mayor. He keeps on putting me in the mayor's race.
Yeah.
It's like about the fifth time he said
that. I know, I keep just putting you on the spot, Debbie. I'm sorry.
Can I add one more thing?
You can do whatever you want.
Good. January 31st is the Super Blue Blood Moon.
The what?
Super Blue Blood Moon.
I can't say that three times fast.
It's going to be Superman.
Okay.
And then it's going to be the...
Oh, blood.
And then it'll be the blood moon.
Blood red? Yeah. And then where's the blue coming from?
It'll be the eclipse everything. So our super moon is when it's closest to the Earth. And then the blue is when we are...
The second full moon in a
month. Right. It's like the half moon. And then our red moon is when we're sitting directly between the sun and the moon, which we can see. It doesn't hurt your eyes to watch. You can take binoculars. You can do anything. But that's January 31st.
Wow. And if you can't see it, Bulger sells stuff for you to see it. So
yeah.
Same. All right. Thanks for everybody that came to the holiday party. That was really a lot of fun. I was trying to put one of our employees on the spot for history and record. I thought she would know everything about that, but I guess
she didn't want to cheat.
Read that before we left.
I didn't know that he was this. You know, no, I didn't know he was the seventh and the ninth mayor. I didn't realize that, so I thought that was kind of cool because like.
Well, I knew Cleveland. It was mayor more than once, but
yeah.
I didn't know it was
well, I saw a little, yeah, some of that. I didn't read all of Vi's history.
Oh.
Yeah. One of the, were you at the, you were at the meeting?
Yeah, but I didn't remember the name.
Yeah, no, it was just one of the things, because they only started keeping records until what, the 40s or 50s? So I'm the 17th mayor, is all. But the 7th and the 9th mayor happened to be Elliot, Cliff Elliot? Mm-hmm. Yeah, back in 75 and then back in 79 or something like that. He ran. And then resigned and ran again. Went, he's like something, I don't know. It was kind of a cool little story. That's it. So next meeting, if anybody else doesn't have anything else, we'll look for a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Motion by Kathy, second by Robin. All in favor, signal by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye.